afford. Today, some extraordinary acts by young people are being celebrated at the Rotary Young Citizen Awards in Manchester. There are 7 winners chosen from hundreds of people nominated across Great Britain and the Republic of Ireland. The awards are now in their 10th year, and winners from the past decade have also travelled to Manchester for this year's celebrations. Let's go live there. Our reporter, Noel Phillips, is there for us. Noel.
That's right, Maxine. Today has been all about celebrating the great achievements of young people. And a lot of the young people here all have one thing in common. They've picked up one of these awards. And most of them all share a sense of a desire and a sense of responsibility to make a difference to their local community. And 2 sisters who have done just that, and they've made quite a big difference, Sophia and Amber Cowburn, who have picked up awards today for simply doing amazing things when it comes to charity. Just tell us about your story, because it all started when you lost your brother, didn't it?
Yeah. So in 2010, our brother, who was 18, suffered from a very small period of mental health issues, and it kind of went downhill really quickly, and he ended up being in a mental health unit. And sadly, we lost him in December 2010. And in January of 2011, our family were obviously grieving and were devastated, and we just decided that we needed to do something to change things, and we needed to raise awareness, we needed to improve services. And so we set up a charity called the Invictus Trust, and we run it as a family. And it was named after his tattoos, because he had the Invictus poem tattooed on his arm. We gave it the anchor logo, and we've been running it ever since.
And I think what's also quite incredible is the fact that you were grieving at the time, and you guys decided to be a little bit proactive, and you've turned grief into success. Just tell us a bit about Ben and what he was like.
Ben was an absolute party animal, sort of life and soul of the party, loved music, fashion. Part of the reason why we took the branding of Invictus so sort of seriously, to make it approachable for young people so that it wasn't sort of really stigmatised by mental health. So like Amber said, we used the poem that he had tattooed on him and the anchor logo. And then a lot of the fundraising we did was all around things that Ben loved, like music gigs, parties, things like that, to really get people in before we started talking to them and then challenging the stigma and changing what was sort of being said about mental health.
I mean, why do we have such a battle in this country when it comes to mental health, especially among young people?
I think for young people today, there's a lot of pressures. I think, you know, with social media and the internet, everything's kind of magnified. Things that you used to be able to kind of turn off when you went home from school, now it carries on around the clock. And I think young people face a lot of pressures with school and with exam pressure and body image and celebrity culture. There's so much going on that I think that is natural that there's going to be more kind of mental health issues. But I think also we talk about them more. So we are going to see higher levels of them. And actually what's really great for us is that the younger generations are the one changing it now. Like, they're destroying the stigma. They're having the language to talk about mental health, they're getting help earlier, and that can only get better.
And fast forward to today, you guys have made quite a big difference, because it's been announced in the last week that after 3 years of relentless campaigning, the NHS will be building its first ever mental health unit in Cornwall, because Cornwall didn't have a mental health unit, and that's all down to you guys. How do you feel?
Yeah, it didn't have adolescent mental health facilities, so for under 18s, there are no facilities. And as a charity, we fund up to 15 families a year to leave Cornwall and travel to see their children, who are as far as 400 miles away to be cared for. So this is amazing, and we just now want to really make sure that the unit is built and changes lives of the children living in Cornwall.
Congratulations, amazing. And you know what, I'm going to hand you your award back. So yours, so have it. Two very worthy winners, Amber and Sophie. And just to let you know, there's a special programme, highlights programme, on the BBC News Channel tonight at 8:30. Young Citizen Awards 2017.
Noel, thank you.